I really have to thank Lego, since they created Indiana Jones 2, Adventure Continues, on my Wii. Why? Because they introduced me to an amazing franchise that has changed cinemas for years to come. And being a fan of Indiana Jones is actually exciting, where you see so many ironic scenes. Like this. And pretty much with that being said, without further ado, let's get into this list of all the Indiana Jones movies ranked from worst to best. And I'm saying this until probably Indiana Jones 5 is out, because Disney better not mess this up.
You're a sunflower. I think your love would be too much, or you'd be left in.
And number four is, what else? Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. I'm not gonna lie, it's not a really good movie, but it does have its good moments, such as the warehouse scene and all the other good moments, like when Indy meets Mother and sees Marion again, and our villain. Overall, the movie is pretty much like an Indiana Jones movie if Disney owned it. And yeah, they did make this. But I hope better for Indiana Jones 5 when it comes. I think, past 3 years. But I want to see better in Indiana Jones 5 than this, because most of it is not that good. Just like all the other three movies, it has some brutality. It's just a lot of very gross scenes in the entire series itself. And basically, Indiana Jones has to retrieve this skull, the crystal skull, from this lady, and it's just see right now is just so gross. Like all these little, are they termites or ants? I have no idea. But this is dark. Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. I'm not gonna lie, this movie is too overrated, especially of its adaptation of after Raiders of the Lost Ark. But it is a good movie because we first get to see Indy's father, and he is a big importance to the entire movie itself, to find the Holy Grail. But overall, the movie is, it's good, but it's too overrated. I mean, it's not as good as Raiders of the Lost Ark, but it is amazing. And honestly, Allison is a very awesome twist character, where she acts like that she is on Indy's side, but she is really part of the Nazi side, or at least German side, whatever. And in Indy's journey with his father is amazing, where they, like I said, find the Holy Grail, but it was to save his father's life. Surprise, surprise, Raiders of the Lost Ark is on number two. Honestly, Raiders of the Lost Ark is one of the greatest movies out there. It's because of John Williams, because of the great music, and George Lucas with the great ideas. It's just so amazing. And who could forget about that scene where he runs for his life and running away from the boulder? It's just a very popular and ironic scene. Who doesn't like this movie? I mean, honestly, yeah, it's on number two, but even though, it's still a great movie to this day. Marin is a great character in Raiders of the Lost Ark, and it's for a good reason too. She does help Indy find this crate. I forgot what it was called, but yeah, they have to stop. They have to retrieve it before Hitler and his army comes. Yeah, Hitler is not in this movie, but he's in The Last Crusade. There is some very good scenes. Sometimes Indiana Jones usually gets gory and or dark, but we'll get to that in number one. But this part is really dark, and for some reason that this part is so dark. If you just look at it, God. That just still creeps me out to this day. And it's so cool that how it's created. Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. Honestly, in my opinion, this is one of the greatest Indiana Jones movies that has ever been released. Just the development, it just seems so cool. And the amount of psychics that Indy's had over the years, these are probably the best ones that he has in the entire franchise. And honestly, Short Round is a great little sidekick, especially for journeys along the way with Indy. I mean, yeah, people said he speaks too loud, and yeah, he, but he's pretty much like a son to Indy, with that not being related to them, but yeah, they seem like family. And Lily is also a great character. Yeah, despite her being so annoying at most times, where she usually screams because of all the other all little animals like snakes, rats, you name it. But honestly, other than that, she is a great character. Despite they had to get rid of her, because after all, Indiana Jones Temple of Doom is a prequel to the entire franchise. And this happened before Raiders of Ark, the Lost Ark. Most of the times in this movie, it just gets dark and gross. Like the heart removal scene. Oh my god, that's just brutal and strange. Like, how can the Indians do that? It's pretty strange. And of course, the ironic scene in this movie, the dinner scene, is just gross. Why would they serve apex or bugs? I mean, it's pretty weird for my taste, because kind of does my appetite, because it's just gross. Just when you look at them eating bugs, or at least the head, inside the head of monkey heads, just sometimes gets so gross for me. Other than that, it's a great movie for me. And of course, it's not as better than Raiders of the Lost Ark. I'm not saying that it's better than Raiders, but Temple of Doom is a good movie. Despite what everyone says about all the characters, all of the entire dialogue, or probably the entire script, but the movie overall is something that most people would enjoy, despite all the dark moments with the food and hearts. I just had a little bit more fun than Raiders because it felt more entertaining, especially the beginning of the movie where it had the ball scene where Indy had escaped, and from the booby traps, and you know what I mean once you watch the movie. But yeah, it's a very, very good movie for my taste.